students, we are back with our science period. Today we are going to start the next lesson, that is topic number 7, that is amazing animal. We are going to start amazing animals. So can you just tell me what is the meaning of amazing? Amazing. Yes, now you say sometimes, wow, what an amazing book it is. It's pretty, very interesting. Am I right? So can you just tell me where do the animals are found? Animals are, you can see the everywhere, the different kinds of animals, am I right? You can see the animals on the land, in the ocean, in the sky. Yes? Where do they live? They live on the trees. Some animals live on the trees, some in the water, some on the land. Yes or no? So animals live at a different places, am I right? And as they live in a different places, how they do weather? Now for example, now see, if you will take a tiger, where the tiger live? Tiger live on the land, am I right? Means in the cave, am I right? Whether the tiger can live on the tree, whether it is comfortable for him? No, according to the body structure, according to the structure of the body, the animal choose their habitat, or we can say the according to the body structure, they find their place to live. They find their place to live. Are you getting? Now, in this lesson, we are going to learn the where do the animals live? Where do the animals live? Before that, we can see what is actually the meaning of habitat. Habitat. Now what is meant by the habitat? The animals, where the animals found very comfortable, the some animals found an area in which particular animals live, grow and reproduce, that is called as a habitat. An area in which the animals can grow, where they can eat, where they can grow, where they can reproduce, that place is called as a habitat. Now for example, if you will see the forest, mostly the animals are found in the forest. Yes or no? Mostly the animals are found in the forest. Am I right? So in the area, but in the forest also, every animal lives on the land? No. Some animals live in the water, some animals live on land, some animals on the tree. Yes or no? For example, the monkey lives on the tree. Am I right? Some animals, that is for lion, tiger lives in the cave or a den. Am I right? Some animals such as birds lives on the tree. Yes, fishes lives in the water. They are comfortable, they can live there. So that is called as a habitat. Now mostly the animals are found in the forest, in the polar region, in the mountains, and in the desert, polar regions and mountain. Am I right? But in this lesson, we are going to learn the animals which are found in the forest. And in the today's video, we are going to discuss only about the forest and the desert area. In today's video, we are going to discuss about two types of habitat where the animals are found, that is in the forest and in the desert. Okay? Now in the forest, mostly the animals are found in the forest. Whether all the animals live together? No, animals, they not live together. Some animals lives in the cave, some animals lives on the tree, some in the water, while some in the soil. Yes or no? For example, tiger and lion lives in the cave or a den. Birds lives on the tree. They build a nest. Am I right? that snakes lives in the hole. Am I right? Well, all the animals, we see that these are the different animals are found in the forest, but they live in a different area. Rabbit lives in the burrow. Rabbit lives in the burrow. Am I right? So these are the animals where the animals are found in the forest, but they live in the different area. They live in the different area. The next habitat is the desert. Deserts are the place where there is a less amount of water, as well as it has a very less green vegetation. Now the sandy area, it is made up of totally a sand. Deserts, if you might have seen, it is made up of totally a sand. But although it is the deserts are of sand, the different animals live there. Why they live there? Because of the body structure. They have built their body structure. We can find the number of animals in desert also. We can get a number of different kinds of animals in the desert. If you will see the climate of the desert, deserts are totally hot in the day, while they are in the night they are totally cold. The deserts are very hot during the days, while during the night they are very cold. So according to that, the animals have built their body structure. They have a very thick skin to protect from this climate. Some animals during the day bury themselves under the sand to protect from this heat. Now you might have heard, in the desert the most common animal found is the camel. Yes or no? Now if you might have seen the camel, now see, this is a camel. Yes, see, it is so called as a desert animal. Now if you will see the structure of the camel, it has a very fat hump. It can store a food and water for a longer time, for a longer period of time. If you will see properly the camel, it has a very long leg. Yes, it has a very long leg. Why is it so? To protect it from the hot sand. Are you getting? So to protect it from the hot sand, it has a very long leg. Are you getting it? Then if you will see the properly, it has a very long eyelashes. Now see, these are the eyelash. What is the use of this eyelash? It protect it from the sand. Yes or no? So similarly, this eyelash, the camel has a very long eyelash. It protect the eyelash from the sand. So this is the structure of the camel. Am I right? It has a very long leg. Then it has a fat hump which can store the food and water for the longer time. In today's video, we will learn only just these two habitats. There are more two habitats where the animals can live, such as in the polar region, in the ocean, that we will learn in the next video. So today's work is that you have to read this lesson. Okay.